guys, this is Nostalgic Days, and we will be doing another real replica weapon on Blacklight Retribution. This time it will be over the XM8 assault rifle that one of my viewers have suggested for me to do. There will be a few changes within the series, which is one, that I will be adding a recoil test, and second of all, Blacklight added a bot mode for me to use rather than just going to live matches. It's just a convenient way just to show off gameplay for it. So yeah, let's get started for the XM8 assault rifle. Now, the background story of the XM8 assault rifle was it's a prototype weapon made for the US military to be the next generation assault rifle. It actually got very, very good specs. The only problem was, I guess, it was its cost on production, and I think that's why the ACR took over for the next generation assault rifles that you have seen today, rather than the XM8 assault rifle. So let's talk about the recoil of the XM8. The XM8 has pretty much good recoil. It goes straight up no matter how you put it, tapping or putting it in full auto. And, you know, the spread deviation is somewhat tight and compact, so you won't be able to see bullets flying off in very, in the cone where it's very large. Instead, it was more compact, so you can see, like, a circular type of spread. Aiming-wise, it's pretty easy to aim, actually. You just point and click, and basically you get the job done. The only problem I would suggest is that if you're going in a close-range battle, you're going to have a hard time, since using the XM8 scope, it's only used for medium to long ranges. It's not suggested for close-quarters combat. So you may have to hip-fire on close-quarters combat. As for range is pretty good. It can be accurate enough just to get the targets. Only problem is, since it sacrificed a lot of damage for accuracy. That's the only problem I can see about it. It's pretty good accurate, but, you know, if you don't have a lot of stopping power, then may have a hard time getting those snipers that are far away or those long-range kills, which kind of is ironic having a medium to long-range scope instead of a close-range scope. So I would suggest that you may have to practice with it and see how comfortable you feel with the assault rifle. And, you know, yeah, you have to make sure you're not in close quarters combat all the time, since it's mainly used for medium to long range combat. As that's about it, I guess. Also, one more thing is that the run, it's usually a lightweight weapon, so you can run really well with it. So it's pretty good for those light class builds, or if you're looking for a lightweight weapon for the heavier class, this may be good for you. My suggestions or my preference to this weapon is, it's okay, but like I said before, the low damage may be a big thing of a turnoff to me, because, you know, I would find myself sometimes trying to hit somebody, like, using a lot of bullets, and they're still not dead. So that's one thing you may have to consider, and you may have to get a better assault rifle than this, like the M4A1 that I have suggested on my last video for. Anyways, that's it for the Blacklight Retribution real replica test. And if there's any more questions, or if you want to suggest another weapon, as long as it's real, and hopefully I can find the parts for it, I can definitely try to make another video of those. So yeah.